I'm so dedicated to my destination. I'ma get it how I live it with no hesitation. See me making moves and all this training proves that I'm possible.
Welcome back to our MLXT YouTube channel, and we're gonna continue our series on training kids, grades 1 through 4, and beginners of the game. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna jump into what we call tennis ball rollouts, and we're gonna use our heavy tennis ball, which you can always use your own tennis ball on this one. But really what we're gonna start doing is we're gonna start challenging a player's ability to dribble, run with the ball, and get low in a moment. Now before we jump into this, let me just say this. Even if you can barely dribble the basketball, you can still do this method. Don't look at it just the way that I do it. Just do it the best way that you can, and it's still gonna give us tremendous value. I'll get back into that in a second, but for now, let's join the workout. Let's take a look at transition rollouts. Now, in this method, what our focus is to be able to continue running at a full speed, at a good speed, while having moments of getting low. A lot of times what we see with a lot of players is they naturally learn over time that when they get low, they also get slower. They slow down. We want to be able to get low and continue at top speed, which means I could be running here, drop down for a second, and continue running without ever breaking that stride. That's a really, really important quality and characteristic for players to learn. And there's no better time to learn that when we're young, we're beginning. And so we can do that great with a transition rollout. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna roll our weighted tennis ball, and I'm gonna let it get out in front of me a little bit. And then I'm just simply gonna sprint through and pick it up off the floor. Now, if you wanna get a finish at the end of it, that's great. But the most important part of it is that we hold ourselves accountable to keeping our run throughout it. So don't stop to pick it up, run through it. And so if I roll it out, I wanna make sure it's a good roll. I let it get out in front of me and I run through it. And then I simply focus on running out of it. Now that could be 1 to 2 dribbles after picking it up or just one, but we wanna make sure that we felt like we did not have to artificially slow down to pick it up. Now here's where it's important to remind ourselves the importance of simply trying things when you're a beginner. But really what I love about workouts like this and methods like this will work whether or not you're a beginner of the game or you're an advanced player. In fact, this is a method that we would do with advanced players. The only difference is of how great they can do it and how easy it's gonna be for some players compared to others. But the method can be used for everybody. Because once again, what we're doing is we're testing your body and we're giving your body the ability to attempt running with the basketball while dribbling and being able to get low during that. Especially when you're young, this is important because our body can be programmed to dribble high when our body is high and dribble low when our body is low. And so if we can start kind of programming ourselves to be able to continue dribbling the ball higher, even in moments where our shoulders gotta drop down, and we can do that without losing speed, these are the types of things that we need to start doing early on before we develop those patterns. And so when you're doing things like this, just remind yourself once again, it's not about your ability to do it well yet. We don't have to be able to do it well. Even if you still slap at the ball while you're dribbling, if you can pick up a tennis ball and be able to do that while keeping that dribble, you're getting there. And then obviously the better you can do it, the more it's gonna be effective for you later on. So the biggest thing is with stuff like this is try it and experiment with your own skills. And of course, if I don't have a finish or even if I do, I just simply do it again. Now right now I'm just showing it back and forth. So I roll it out, I can go a little bit higher speed this time, then I simply gotta chase it down and be able to run out at the end of it. And so that's really what you're studying when you do this, is that I can continue just keeping my steps normal, even though there's moments of dropping my shoulders. Then of course, same thing going opposite. If I'm dribbling with my left hand, I roll that ball out, I'm going through it, I'm making sure that my timing stays the same on my dribble, and I'm able to run all the way through that. If our timing starts to get random, if we start losing control just because my body had to get low, that's a warning sign we wanna start working on right now. So those are transition rollouts. Spend 15 to 20 minutes, obviously going both ways, adding and finishing if you need to, but making sure that we can run through those low moments. And that wraps up transition rollouts, a great way for beginners to train and also a great way for anyone to train. How far you take it is literally going to be up to where you are and how easy it is for you. But everybody can be doing stuff like this. And that's the main thing that we're trying to get across when it comes to kids. We don't need to underestimate you. We don't necessarily have to do everything building you up from the ground up. We can throw you right into the fire sometimes, and that will pay big dividends in your game later on. Now, obviously there's gonna be times where we gotta go back to more basic and just work on dribbling mechanics, which we will. But even if you're not a master of those things yet, testing your body's ability to get on the run and pick something up is going to be great for you. And if you're an advanced player, this will still work for you. The only difference now is how fast you can take it, what kind of things that you can throw into the mix. You can start driving on curves, get right to a finish, you can mix it up. And so as you get better with things like this, just simply increase the difficulty, increase your speed, and it will work for you. And if you like this content, make sure that you're subscribed. Make sure that you go ahead and like this, comment, that always helps, and of course, ring the notification bell so you always will know exactly when the next one's going to come. But obviously, we're gonna be doing this every single week right at this time. So we'll see you next week on MLXT YouTube channel.